大家好，
Hello, everyone.
今天我要跟大家分享的题目是宝座前的敬拜。
Today, I'd like to share with you the topic on throne room worship.
因为从2023年开始，我们教会的祷告会将要转化成敬拜会。
Because from 2023,Our prayer meeting in the church will be transformed into a worship gathering.
我们尝试的来操练宝座前的敬拜。
We want to try to practice throne room worship.
这时候让我们做一个开始的祷告。
At this time, let us have an opening prayer.
天父，我们感谢你今天与我们同在。
Father God, we thank you that you are here with us today.
我们相信你的心意就是要你的百姓来到你的宝座前全心的敬拜你。
We believe that your heart is for us to come before your throne to be able to worship you with all of our hearts.
所以天父，这时候我们求你亲自的向我们说话。
So Father God, we ask that now that you come and speak to us personally.
教导我们什么是宝座前的敬拜。
Teach us what is throne room worship.
愿你圣灵亲自的打开我们心中的耳朵，让我们听见主你的声音。
May your Holy Spirit just open the ears of our heart that we will be able to hear your voice.
因为你说一句话，胜过人说一千句话。
Because when you speak one word, it is better than the words, a thousand words of man.
我们把以下的时间交托在你的手上。
And so therefore, we commit the rest of the time into your hands.
这样的祈求祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
And so we pray this in the holy name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
到底宝座前的敬拜是一个怎么样的敬拜呢？
So what exactly is throne room worship?
那宝座前的敬拜跟平时我们的敬拜又有什么不同呢？
What is the difference between throne room worship and the usual practice of worship?
那如果我们要了解宝座前的敬拜，我们要首先明白为什么大卫要设立他的那个帐幕来敬拜上帝。
So if we want to understand throne room worship, we must first understand why did King David establish his tabernacle?
当大卫把这个约柜带回来的时候，
When King David brought back the Ark of Covenant,
他没有把它放在摩西的会幕里面。
He did not place it in the tabernacle of Moses.
当时摩西的会幕在基遍这个地方。
At that time, the tabernacle of Moses was at Gibeon.
祭司们每一天在那个祭坛上献祭。
The priests would offer sacrifices daily at the tabernacle of Moses.
他们会进入到圣所来点那个灯，来烧那个香，来吃那个陈设饼。
And they would also enter into the holy place, and they would actually light up, the lamp. They would also eat the table from the bread, the table of showbread, and they would also offer incense at the altar of incense.
那为什么大卫没有把约柜放在摩西的会幕里面呢？
So,Why did David not put the Ark of Covenant in the tabernacle of Moses?
相反的，他把它带到锡安山，自己搭一个帐幕，把上帝的约柜放在锡安山上。
To the contrary, he actually established his own tabernacle on Mount Zion, specially for the Ark.
为什么上帝允许大卫这样的自作主张呢？
And why did actually God allow David to do this?
原来摩西的会幕的重点跟大卫帐幕的重点是完全不一样的。
And we discover that it is actually because the priority or the key of the tabernacle of David and that of the tabernacle of Moses are entirely different.
摩西的会幕的重点是讲到上帝要救赎他的百姓。
The key or the main point about the tabernacle of Moses is that of redemption.
所以大祭司每一年一次进入到至圣所，在约柜前来为以色列百姓赎罪。
And therefore, at the tabernacle of Moses, the high priest would enter into the Holy of Holies once a year to be able to make atonement for the people of Israel.
但是对大卫来说，上帝救赎他已经是一个不争的一个事实。
However, we find that for David, the redemption of God was already such a real experience.
他一辈子经历不同大大小小上帝的救赎。
And for his whole life, he actually experienced the redemption of God in big things and in small things.
所以他非常的确定上帝肯定会救赎他。
And so therefore, he was so very convinced that God indeed would redeem him.
所以他心中充满了感恩的心。
And therefore, his heart was full of gratitude.
他要把那个赞美、那个敬拜、那个感谢献上给上帝。
And so therefore, he just wanted to offer that praise, that adoration, that thanksgiving to God.
这就是为什么他不把那个约柜放回去摩西的会幕里面，他自己设立一个帐幕。
And it is for this reason that David did not put the Ark of Covenant in the tabernacle of David and instead established his own tabernacle.
因为他非常的渴慕上帝的同在。
Because he longed so much for the presence of God.
因为这两个会幕它的重点它的焦点是不一样。
Because the focus of each of these tabernacles was so very different.
所以他们的那个运作在那边的这一个活动也是不一样的。
So therefore, the operation and the activities of these two tabernacles were also very different.
在摩西的会幕里面强调的是那个献祭。
And so for the tabernacle of David, the emphasis, tabernacle of Moses, the emphasis was on sacrifice.
但是在大卫的帐幕里面，那一个所强调的是敬拜。
However, for the tabernacle of David, the emphasis was on worship.
从大卫的帐幕里面，我们首先看到人间第一个的在宝座前的敬拜。
And so therefore, from the tabernacle of David, we then see that this was the first experience of man in throne room worship.
这就是为什么上帝说在末后的日子，他要重新建立大卫倒塌的帐幕。
And it is for this reason that God said that in the last days, he will establish the tabernacle of David that had been fallen down.
这是因为耶稣基督已经完成了那个救赎。
Because Jesus had already completed redemption.
救赎的问题已经是解决了问题。
In fact, what it means that the problem was, which was actually already solved by redemption.
所以上帝现在渴慕被救赎的人来到他的宝座前献上他们的赞美和敬拜。
So therefore God longed for those who had already been redeemed to come before the throne to be able to offer their worship.
这就是为什么在末后的日子上帝要重新建立大卫倒塌的帐幕而不是摩西的会幕。
And it is for this reason that in the last days, God is going to establish the tabernacle of David that had fallen down and not the tabernacle of Moses.
那到底什么是宝座前的敬拜呢?
Then, what exactly is throne room worship?
它跟我们一般的敬拜又有什么不同的地方呢?
And what is the difference between throne room worship and the normal way in which we worship?
首先第一点，宝座前的敬拜不是演出。
First, it is not a performance.
很多的时候，今天在我们的教会里面，我们的崇拜聚会，我们有的时候那个焦点不是在上帝上，我们的焦点是在人的身上。
Many times in our normal church services, the focus is actually not on God, but actually on man.
我们非常的注重那个灯光，那个舞台的效果。
We actually pay a lot of attention on the lighting, on actually what happens on the platform.
我们非常的注重那个音乐，那个唱歌的人的这个表现。
We are actually very focused actually on the music, we're very focused actually on the performance of those on stage.
甚至我们要有烟雾来营造那个氛围，那个气氛。
And sometimes we even have smoke in order to create that atmosphere.
那我不是说这些都是错，我不是说这些都不好。
I'm not saying that this is wrong. I'm not saying that this is no good.
但是当我们注重在这样的一种的呈现我们的敬拜的时候，有的时候会变成是一个演出。
However, when we focus on all these things, then sometimes this then becomes a performance.
有的时候那个焦点会从宝座上的大君王的身上转移到人的身上。
And because of that, the focus then becomes not the Lord of hosts, but man.
几年前我到了德国去参加一个代祷者的聚会。
A few years ago, I attended an intercessors meeting in Germany.
有一场的敬拜使我毕生难忘。
And there was a particular worship service that till now I remember.
我还记得那一天领事的是一个怀孕的一个姐妹。
And I remember that the worship leader was a pregnant woman.
她到台上的时候，她很坦白地告诉整个的会众。
And so when she went on stage, she very frankly told everyone,
她说我们没有预备任何一首诗歌。
She said that we did not prepare any song.
我们也没有任何的彩排。
We also did not practice.
我们今天只是来敬拜上帝。
And that today we're just coming to worship the Lord.
所以让我们大家一起的来敬拜上帝。
So let us together worship the Lord.
然后他就开始唱灵歌。
And then so she then began to sing in the spirit.
那么那整个乐队就跟着他一起弹奏起来。
And the entire worship team then began to play the instruments together with her.
过了一段时间之后，他就唱了一首大家熟悉的歌曲。
And after some time, she then began to sing a familiar song.
然后整个的会众就跟着他一起唱。
And the entire congregation then just followed her to sing.
整个的那个聚会的氛围，你真的感觉到上帝的恩膏，上帝的同在。
And you can sense in the entire atmosphere throughout the meeting, God's anointing, God's presence.
虽然那个音乐不是很协调，因为他们没有彩排。
And even though the music, in a sense, was not so in harmony because they had not rehearsed,
但是大家都是在全心全意的敬拜上帝。
But everyone was just wholeheartedly just worshiping the Lord.
这就是宝座前的敬拜。
And so this is throne room worship.
他不是在讨人的喜悦。
It is not to please man.
他不是在吸引人的眼光。
It is not actually to attract the attention of man.
他甚至不在意人家怎么样的评论他。
And in fact, you know, in total disregard of man's assessment.
因为他来到上帝面前是要全心的敬拜上帝。
Because when they come before God, it is really just wholeheartedly to worship him.
因为宝座上的君王在宝座前的敬拜是唯一的焦点。
Because the only focus is the king seated on the throne.
今天有的时候我们在台上带领赞美敬拜的时候，我们很在意会众的反应是怎么样。
Oftentimes when we're on the stage leading worship, we are actually very attentive or very careful regarding the reaction of the people.
这会往往使到我们的焦点从上帝的宝座前转移到会众的身上。
And so because of this, the focus then is actually transferred from the king seated on the throne to the people.
这就不是一个宝座前的敬拜。
Then it doesn't become throne room worship.
当你来到上帝宝座前的敬拜，有三件事情你必须要非常的留意，不要去做这三件事情。
Because in throne room worship, there are actually three things that you have to be very careful about not to do.
第一，你来到宝座前的敬拜，你不要闭上你的嘴巴。
First, when we come before the throne in worship, please don't just shut your mouth.
因为这对上帝来说是一个很大的不敬。
Because this is very disrespectful.
你怎么可以来到宝座前敬拜他，但是你却不开口呢？
How can you come before the throne and worship and yet not open your mouth?
你一定要从你的口里面发出一些声音来敬拜他，来称颂他。
You need to actually to worship God aloud, and you need to just to praise and exalt Him.
第二件事情，你千万不要东张西望。
And number two is, please don't look around.
你到宝座前的敬拜，你的眼目不要放在任何一个人的身上。
When you come before the throne to worship, then please let your eyes not settle on any person.
甚至连那个诗歌的那个歌词，你也不要放在那边。
And even, you know, just don't just look at the lyrics of the song.
因为那个歌词不是太重要。
Because the lyrics are not so important.
而是在宝座上的大君王才是重要。
But the most important would be the king seated on the throne.
你现在看，如果上帝的宝座现在在你的前面，这位大君王坐在你的前面，你的眼目可以转到别的地方去吗？
Can you imagine if the throne was actually in front of you and the king is seated on that throne, would your eyes be on anything else?
今天我们的敬拜，我们很容易就会分心。
So in fact, in today's kind of worship, we find that our attention is actually quite distracted.
我们会被那个投影出来的那个画面来分我们的心。
In fact, we can actually be quite distracted by the PowerPoint projection.
我们会被那个乐队的穿着，他们的音乐分我们的心。
We can actually also be distracted by the worship team's clothing, actually, you know, by the music.
我们甚至会因为四周围的人的反应而使我们分心。
And in fact, we can actually also be distracted by the response of the people around us.
在宝座前的敬拜，你不要分心，你要专心。
However, in throne room worship, there is no distraction. We are just totally focused on God Himself.
当你来到宝座前的敬拜的时候，不要把你的手机拿出来。
And so, when you come into throne room worship, please don't take out your handphones.
因为你的手机是最容易让你分心的。
Because your mobile phones can easily distract you.
难道你手机里面的信息或者是任何的这一个内容会比上帝来的更重要吗？
Do you mean that actually the messages that you receive on your mobile phone or the content of your mobile phone is actually more important than God?
其实如果可以的话，我们甚至连手机也不要带进这个敬拜的场所。
Maybe if possible, we just don't bring in our mobile phones into the sanctuary where we are worshipping.
因为在敬拜的场所是分别为圣的。
Because that sanctuary is set apart and holy for the Lord.
我们的手机里面有很多属世的东西。
There are many earthly things in our mobile phones.
严格的说，它是一个不圣洁的物品。
Strictly speaking, it's actually not a holy device.
所以在你在宝座前敬拜的时候，你不要看你的手机。
So therefore, when you are engaged in throne room worship, please don't look at your mobile phones.
第三，你的所有的敬拜要处于你的心灵。
Thirdly, the worship must come from the heart, from the spirit.
你的焦点放在宝座上的君王，然后你的声音要处于你的心灵。
So the attention is actually focused on God seated on the throne, and the sound must come from within the heart.
无论这个声音是一个怎么样的声音，
regardless of what that sound is,
就算它里面没有那个文字，只有一个声音，只要是出自于你的心灵，这个就是对上帝的一个敬拜。
So it could be that this sound that comes out is actually wordless. But that's okay, because that sound then can constitute worship unto the Lord.
让我们来到宝座前，我们从我们的内心的最深的地方发出那个感恩的心声音出来。
So when we come before the throne in worship, oh, just let that sound of gratitude just come from the deepest places within our hearts.
这个声音对上帝来说是非常的重要，因为这个声音就是对他的一种尊荣，对他的一种崇拜。
And that sound emanating from deep within our heart is very important because that sound is actually the sound of exaltation, of worship unto the Lord.
因为只有上帝的灵才能够带领我们进入到宝座前敬拜上帝。
Only the Holy Spirit can lead us into the throne room to worship the Lord.
你跟我不知道怎么样的来到宝座前敬拜。
You and I actually don't know how to do this.
但是我们愿意的话，上帝的灵会引领我们，会带领我们。
However, if we are willing, then the Spirit of God will actually lead us and guide us into the throne room.
所以在宝座前的敬拜，你要完全学会顺服圣灵的感动。
So in throne room worship, we need to learn how to totally submit to the prompting of the Holy Spirit.
圣灵感动你站起来，你就要站起来。
If the Holy Spirit prompts you to stand, please stand.
圣灵告诉你要跪下去，你就要跪下去。
If the Holy Spirit tells you kneel, then please kneel.
圣灵感动你要发出这个声音，你就要发出这个声音。
If the Holy Spirit just moves you to say, you know, just make this sound, then do make that sound.
甚至圣灵感动你跳舞，你就要跳舞。
And if the Holy Spirit prompts you to dance, then please dance.
你不要管旁边的人。
Don't care about other people.
不要管别人怎么样看你。
Don't care about what others think of you.
因为现在只是只有你跟上帝的一个很独特的时间。
Because this is a time actually between you and God, a very special and unique time.
只要你不影响到别人。你可以做上帝要你做的事情。
So long as you don't influence other people, you can do what God wants you to do.
当我们一消灭圣灵的感动的时候，
However, when we just eliminate or extinguish that prompting of the Holy Spirit,
当我们因为面子怕人家笑我们，我们不愿意做圣灵感动我们所应该做的事情的时候，我们就离开了这个宝座前的敬拜。
So maybe it's because of faith, you know, we are afraid regarding what other people think of us. The moment we think that, then we are actually leaving that kind of throne room worship.
因为你不顺服圣灵的话，你怎么能够继续的在宝座前敬拜？
Because if you don't submit to the Holy Spirit, how can you worship before the throne?
而更重要的，敬拜不是一个属灵的活动，它是一个二十四气的生活方式。
Most importantly, worship is not just a spiritual activity, but it is a 24/7 lifestyle.
你每天的生活、你的工作、你跟人的关系，其实都是对上帝的一个敬拜。
So every day, 24/7, your work, your relationships with people, all of these constitute worship unto the Lord.
你平时要非常的认知上帝与你同在。
And so every day is just to be consciously aware of the presence of the Lord with you.
甚至每一天自己在家里，在自己的房间里面操练宝座前的敬拜。
And every day in your own room, just practice engaging in throne room worship.
这样你就能够很容易的进入到宝座前的敬拜。
And in that way,It's very easy for you to enter into throne room worship.
但是你平时不敬拜上帝。
However, if normally you don't worship the Lord,
你平时你基本上不理他。
Normally you just disregard the Lord, you just ignore him.
而每个星期二你来到敬拜会的时候，你想会突然之间你进入到宝座前的敬拜，我恐怕会有困难。
And then every Tuesday during the worship gathering, you come and you hope to actually to have throne room worship. I think it would be very challenging indeed to do so.
所以有的时候当我们聚集的时候，有的人敬拜非常的投入。
So there are, when we gather together, there are some who are just so totally engaged in throne room worship.
有的人领受了很多。
And there are some who actually receive so much.
但是有的人却不知所措。
But there are some who actually don't know what's happening.
他们觉得自己没有什么的领受，没有什么的感动，没有什么的感觉。
And so, you know, they feel, oh, you know, I have no feeling, no reaction, no response. I receive nothing from the Lord.
问题不是出于那一个聚会。
And so the problem is actually not with the gathering itself.
而问题是出在这个人的身上。
But the problem is actually with that person.
所以宝座前的敬拜之前的这个预备是非常的重要。
So therefore, the preparation before throne room worship becomes very important.
摩西的会幕就教导我们怎么样的预备我们自己来到宝座前的敬拜。
The tabernacle of Moses instructs us regarding what we need to do to prepare for throne room worship.
我们每一天要带着感谢进入上帝的院。
So every day, we come with thanksgiving into the courts of the Lord.
我们每一天要筑起我们的个人的祷告祭坛。
And so every day, we need to build our own prayer altar.
因为在祷告祭坛，它是一个除罪的系统。
Because the prayer altar is actually a system for repentance and for atonement.
所以我们在这个祷告祭坛，我们就深入的悔改。
And so therefore, at the prayer altar, we engage in deep repentance.
上帝宝座前的敬拜是一个很神圣的敬拜，是一个要分别为圣的敬拜。
The throne room worship is such a holy worship. Yes, it is such a holy worship.
因为上帝的宝座是全世界最神圣的一个地方。
Because the most holy place in all the earth is really the throne room.
所以我们要天天的自洁祷告。
And so therefore, every day, we need to cleanse ourselves, we need to pray.
当我们深入的悔改的时候，我们就来到洗座盆，被上帝来洁净我们。
And so when we come into deep repentance, then we come to the brazen laver, and there we then receive the cleansing of the Lord.
过后我们就进入到圣所里面。
After that,We come into the holy place.
我们让圣灵的光照进我们的心中。
And so we allow the light of the Holy Spirit to enter into our hearts.
在祷告祭坛里面，我们经常说我们要驱除外面的黑暗。
And so therefore, there we can say that we just want to dispel the darkness.
但是我们首先必须要驱除我们自己内心的黑暗，我们才有权柄驱除外在的黑暗。
But the only way in which we can dispel the darkness outside is if we first dispel the darkness within.
所以当我们筑坛祷告的时候，我们求上帝的灵天天的光照我们。
So therefore, when we pray at the prayer altar, we then ask for the Lord actually to every day just to enlighten us by the Holy Spirit.
让他的光照进我们的内心里面的每一个角落。
That his light will actually shine on every part of us.
让我们一有任何的这个缺点，任何的过犯，我们立刻就深入的悔改。
And that whatever sin we have, whatever fault we have, then we quickly repent before the Lord.
这是天天操练的一件事情。
And so this is an everyday occurrence.
一个错误的态度。
And so even a wrong attitude.
一句错误的话。
And it could be maybe something which is said which is wrong.
甚至一个字我们讲了伤害到人，我们都要悔改。
It could even be a word that you have said that could have actually hurt someone else. We need to repent.
当你愿意被圣灵光照的时候，圣灵就会光照你，告诉你什么地方你需要改过。
And if you're willing to allow the Holy Spirit to shine His light on us, He will do so and will teach us what areas in our lives that we need to repent of.
过后我们就到陈设饼来吃神的话。
And then after that, we come to the table of showbread to eat the Word of God.
因为这个陈设饼就是生命的粮食。
Because the word of God is actually our bread of life.
所以在祷告祭坛里面，我们强调每一个人要每天大量读圣经。
And so therefore, at the prayer altar, we emphasize that every day we need to read large portions of scripture.
这个都是在预备我们进入宝座前的敬拜。
And so all this is in preparation for us to enter into throne room worship.
过后我们来到香坛。 就为国家、为社会、为教会、为家人代祷代求。
And then we come to the altar of incense, and there we then intercede actually for ourselves, our families, for the nation.
这些都是我们天天必须要操练的。
And this is something that we need to practice every day.
而这一些都是为了预备我们能够坦然无惧地进入到宝座前敬拜。
So all of this is actually to prepare us to come boldly in order to engage in throne room worship.
在宝座前的敬拜里面是没有悔改的。
Worship before the throne does not have any repentance.
因为你在之前你就已经要悔改。
Because you have already repented before.
你要在悔改之后你才进入到宝座前的敬拜。
It is only after repentance that you come into the throne room to worship.
在宝座前的敬拜甚至没有代祷。
In throne room worship, there is also no intercession.
因为上帝才是你的焦点，不是任何一个人的需要，是你的焦点。
Because the focus is actually on God and not on the problem of any person.
上帝早就知道我们的需要。
In fact, God already knows our needs.
你来到宝座前的敬拜，你不需要再重复告诉上帝你的需要是什么。
So when we come into the throne room to worship, we don't need to tell God again because he already knows what actually are our problems.
宝座前的敬拜你是不重要的。
And so in throne room worship, actually you are not important.
上帝才是最重要。
Because the most important is God himself.
在宝座前的敬拜里面只有敬拜，只有称颂上帝，只有宣告神的话。
In throne room worship, there is only worship. There is only hallowing of God's name. There is only the declaration of God's word.
在启示录第四章就给我们看到一个真正宝座前的敬拜的光景。
And we find that Revelations 4:8 depicts actually a scene of throne room worship.
在启示录第四章里面你读不到悔改。
In Revelations 4:8, you don't read about repentance.
在启示录第四章里面你读不到代祷。
In Revelations 4:8, you do not read about intercession.
在启示录第四章里面你只读到敬拜。
In Revelations 4, you only read about worship.
所以他们是昼夜不住的说，圣哉圣哉，主神是既在今在以后永在的全能者。
And day and night, they never cease to say, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come.
这就是为什么大卫的帐幕是一个很了不起的帐幕。
And that is why the tabernacle of David is such a great tabernacle.
因为它是在圣经里面所记载的第一个24小时七天不间断的向上帝献上赞美和敬拜的一个帐幕。
Because in the Bible, this is the first ever record of 24/7 worship unto the Lord.
我不知道大卫怎么知道在上帝宝座前的敬拜是一个24小时不停的敬拜。
I don't know how David knew, actually, that throne room worship is unceasing 24/7 worship.
但是他却知道，所以他的帐幕没有代祷，没有赎罪，他的帐幕只有24次不停的赞美敬拜。
However, he knew, and so therefore, in the tabernacle of David, there is only 24/7 worship before the Lord.
而且他在那边宣告神的名，宣告神的旨意。
And so there he also declares God's name, he declares God's will.
在历代志上25章第一节
1 Chronicles 25:1 says,
当大卫和众首领分派人来在这个帐幕24小时赞美敬拜的时候
And that when David and his commanders set apart for the service, some people for 24/7 worship,
圣经说唱歌原文是说预言。
And so the original word for singing is actually prophesying.
换句话说他们是对齐上帝的宝座前的敬拜。
In other words, they were actually aligned with the worship in heaven before the throne.
他们赞美敬拜上帝。
And so therefore they were praising and worshiping God.
他们唱歌，然后他们也同时的说预言。
And so they were singing it at the same time they were also prophesying.
这个就是我们所要操练的。
And so this is something that we also want to engage in.
上帝渴慕他在天上的这个敬拜有一天在地上也会发生。
And so God longs for the fact that the worship before his heavenly throne will one day also happen on earth.
Amen.
Amen.
我们不久前开始了 SG247.
And so not long ago, we started SG247.
我们要建立一个祷告城墙来保护新加坡。
We want to establish a prayer wall to protect Singapore.
我相信上帝也要建立一个二十四期的敬拜中心。
I believe that God also wants to establish a 24/7 center of worship.
新加坡需要一个祷告的城墙来保护它。
Singapore needs actually a prayer wall to protect her.
新加坡更需要有大卫帐幕的敬拜，一直不断的敬拜和宣告神的旨意设立在新加坡。
Singapore needs even more to have a tabernacle of David established in Singapore for 24/7 worship.
以便上帝的宝座能够降临在新加坡。
So that the throne of God can come on Singapore.
新加坡能够成为上帝的一个居所。
And that Singapore then can become a dwelling place for God.
所以每个星期二当我们聚集的时候，我们就尝试的操练这个宝座前的敬拜。
So therefore, every Tuesday when we gather to worship, we want to try to engage in throne room worship.
我们每个星期二要做什么呢？
So what do we do every Tuesday?
它分成三部分。
And so it's divided into three sections.
第一是寻求主的面。
The first section is to seek His face.
在六点半开始，我们就在这个会堂那边预备我们的心，将自己献上给上帝，做直接的祷告。
And so from 6:30 onwards, we actually come to prepare ourselves, we come to cleanse ourselves, and we come to pray.
我们要留心听圣灵有什么的吩咐。
And at that time, we also want to listen carefully to what the Holy Spirit has to say to us.
所以我鼓励大家能够提早来的话，在六点半就来到这个场所那边预备你的心。
So I would like to encourage everyone to actually come at 6:30 in order to prepare our hearts.
那如果你不能够这么早到的话，没关系，在你的路上你也预备你的心。
However, if you can't come at 6:30, it's okay. But if you're on the way, just prepare your hearts.
不要再闲谈。
Oh, don't just talk casually.
不要再做一些属世的东西。
You know, just don't do any sort of like fleshly or earthly things.
然后开始用方言祷告，预备你的心来朝见你的上帝。
And then begin to pray in tongues to prepare our hearts to be able to come to seek God.
如果你六点半到了会场的话
And if you come at 6:30
不要跟人家讲话
Then please don't engage in conversation
这不是一个社交的时候
Because this is not a time for fellowship
这是一个寻求上帝的时候
It is a time for seeking the face of God
这是一个洁净自己的时候
It is a time for cleansing of ourselves
这是一个聆听圣灵的吩咐的时候
It is a time to listen to God's instructions
然后七点半开始我们就有一个开场的祷告。
And then at 7:30, we will begin with an opening prayer.
我们会吹号角。
We will have shofar blowing.
然后我们开始一起用方言祷告。
And then together, we will begin to pray in tongues.
因为方言是一个属灵的言语。
Because praying in tongues is a spiritual language.
它会带领我们进入到一个属灵的境界。
And it will enable us to enter into the spiritual realm.
它会营造一个属灵的氛围
and it will actually create a spiritual atmosphere.
那七点半开始，我们正式的进入到这个宝座前的敬拜
And then at 7:30, we will then begin throne room worship.
我们要进入到上帝的同在
We want to enter into His presence.
我们至少有45分钟的时间来敬拜
We will have worship for at least 45 minutes.
因为那一天在台上的敬拜者，他没有事先预备那个诗歌。
Because on that day, the person on stage who is worshiping won't have prepared his songs.
他是在圣灵的感动之下，他会唱出诗歌来。
And so he will sing according to the prompting of the Holy Spirit.
而我们会众就与他一同的敬拜上帝。
And so we as a congregation will then also together worship with him.
所以有的时候那个歌词是没有事先预备好要投影出来。
So there are times probably, you know, when we find that there is no projection of the songs or the projection is late.
没关系。
It doesn't matter.
不要被这件事情来打扰你。
Don't be distracted by these things.
有歌词没歌词你都可以敬拜。
Regardless of whether there are song lyrics, whether there are no lyrics, you can still worship.
你也可以发出一个声音来跟着这一个音调来献上给上帝。
You can actually release a sound and you can just follow with the music to worship the Lord.
注意在宝座前的敬拜是没有领诗的。
And remember, in throne room worship, there is no worship leader.
因为他不会带领你。
Because he's actually not leading you.
他是在自己在敬拜上帝。
He himself is also just worshiping the Lord.
因为如果他带领你的话，他要关心你，他要眼目注重在你的反应是怎么样。
Because the moment he worship leads, then what it means that he has to actually pay attention to you.
但是在宝座前的敬拜，他只需要关心上帝，眼目集中在上帝的身上，而不是在你的身上。
However, in throne room worship, his focus is really on God and not on you.
所以当我们敬拜的时候，有的时候上帝的话语就会下来。
And so when we worship, there are times when actually God's word comes.
有的时候上帝的这个意象就会显现出来。
Sometimes God gives us a vision.
那时候我们就宣告上帝的旨意。
And at that time, we then declare God's will.
弟兄姐妹，我要你知道，这个宣告比我们的祷告是更有能力的。
And so, brothers and sisters, I would want you to know that this kind of prophetic declaration is even more powerful than our prayers.
因为我们所宣告的这个信息的内容是来自宝座前的。
Because whatever we declare is actually from the throne.
这是一个 Rhema 的一个话语。
And this is the Rhema word.
上帝口中所说出去的话绝不突然返回。
And so therefore, the word that comes from God will not return to him void.
他必成就上帝的旨意所要成就的。
But it will accomplish that for which it was sent.
有的时候我们领受了一个信息，我们会做先知性的分享。
And so there are times when we receive actually a message from the Lord, and so therefore we will share prophetically.
这不是一个教导。
This is not a teaching.
也不是一个讲道，
it is actually not a sermon,
而是领受了上帝的信息，分享给大家，让大家明白这个信息是什么意思。
But rather, it is actually something which is received from the Lord himself and sharing it with others so that there can be understanding.
所以我称它为先知性的分享。
And so therefore, I call this prophetic sharing.
当我们在宝座前敬拜之后，
So after we worship at the throne,
我们就出来彼此的祝福。
Then we will come out and then we will bless one another.
来到了第三段，基本上这个宝座前的敬拜就已经停止了。
And so this is the third phase. And in the third phase, we would already have ceased throne room worship.
我们分成小组彼此的祝福。
We will break into small groups to bless one another.
因为祭司们在这个圣所服侍完上帝之后，他出来就是祝福神的百姓。
Because when the priests, after they had served in the holy place, they would come out and they would bless the people.
而我们每一个人都是君尊的祭司。
And every one of us are actually priests.
所以我们要彼此的祝福。
So therefore, we want to bless each other.
最后我们要宣告上帝的医治要临到。
Then lastly, we want to declare that his healing will come.
就是上帝的旨意要医治他的百姓。
Because God's will is to heal his people.
所以我们要祷告上帝的医治会临到上帝的百姓。
And so therefore we want to declare and pray for his healing to come upon his people.
最后我们给大祭司的祝福之后，我们就可以散会。
And then lastly, we will have the Aaronic blessing, and after that we can leave.
所以我鼓励大家预备你的心来到星期二的敬拜会，来一起的进入到宝座前来敬拜我们的上帝。
So I would like to encourage everyone, prepare our hearts to come on Tuesdays to worship the Lord at his throne.
今天上帝要在全地重新的建立起大卫倒塌的帐幕。
Today, the Lord wants to establish once again the tabernacle of David which has fallen down.
在使徒行传十五章十六节到十七节，上帝告诉我们，当他大卫的帐幕被重新修造的时候，剩余的人，就是凡称呼我名下的外邦人，都会寻求主。
In Acts 15, 16 to 17, the Lord tells us that after this I will return and will rebuild the tabernacle of David which has fallen down. I will rebuild its ruins and I will set it up so that the rest of mankind may seek the Lord, even all the Gentiles who are called by my name, says the Lord who does all these things.
这个大卫倒塌的帐幕，它有一个特点，就是当它被建立起来的时候，许多的人就要得救。
And so a very special feature about the tabernacle of David is that when it is rebuilt, that many people will come into salvation.
因为当上帝的宝座降临的时候，黑暗的权势就要被驱逐出去。
Because when the throne of God comes down, then we find that darkness will be dispelled.
Amen.
Amen.
所以让我们尽我们最大的力量来尝试进入到宝座前的敬拜。
So therefore, let us make the utmost effort to come and to practice throne room worship.
我鼓励大家来参加我们星期二晚上的敬拜会。
I would like to encourage everyone, come and attend our Tuesday worship gatherings.
愿上帝祝福大家。
May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Amen.